गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग लेसन नंबर 8, एल्गोरिथम एंड फ्लो चार्ट। चिल्ड्रन, टुडे फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट एल्गोरिथम। एल्गोरिथम इज अ सीक्वेंस ऑफ एक्टिविटीज वी परफॉर्म्ड टू गेट द आउटपुट फ्रॉम अ गिवन इनपुट। वी राइट एल्गोरिथम इन अ सिंपल इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज टू सॉल्व एनी मैथमेटिकल और लॉजिकल प्रॉब्लम्स। टू राइट एन एल्गोरिथम चिल्ड्रन, वी विल फॉलो द स्टेप्स। फर्स्ट वी विल एनालाइज द प्रॉब्लम that we have to solve with the help of algorithm. Second, we will decide the inputs that we require. Third thing, we will decide the outputs, result we want. Next, we will decide the steps, process. With the help of that, we will achieve the result. See, in this example, we want to calculate area of circle with the help of radius r. सो चिल्ड्रन, फर्स्ट वी विल डिसाइड इनपुट एंड आउटपुट फॉर द प्रॉब्लम। हम पहले इनपुट डिसाइड करेंगे। इनपुट क्या होगा इस क्वेश्चन में? रेडियस आर। देन वी विल डिसाइड द आउटपुट, दैट विल बी द एरिया ऑफ सर्कल। नेक्स्ट वी विल डिसाइड हाउ वी विल कैलकुलेट द एरिया ऑफ सर्कल। एज वी नो, वी विल यूज पाई आर स्क्वायर टू सॉल्व द एरिया ऑफ सर्कल। नाउ चिल्ड्रन, वी विल राइट एल्गोरिथम। फर्स्ट वी विल स्टार्ट विद द reading the radius, read r. Next step, we will calculate the area with the help of pi r square, and after calculating the area, we will print the area in the next step. And finally, we will use stop keyword to indicate that we have completed algorithm. In next example, you will see we have to find the sum of two numbers. For that, input will be the two numbers and output will be the addition of two numbers. Now children, we will write algorithm. We will start with a start keyword. हम algorithm को start keyword से start करेंगे, जो indicate करता है कि हम algorithm start कर रहे हैं. Next step, we will read number one, then we will read number two, and after getting the two numbers, we will use calculation, that is sum equals to number one plus number two. After getting the result, children, we will print the result, that is print sum. And then we will use AND keyword to indicate that we have completed the algorithm. So this way we will write the algorithms. Children, there are some characteristics of an algorithm. First, algorithm should be easy to understand. Then in algorithm, there should be input and output clearly defined, that what input and how many inputs we require and what output we require from the algorithm. Every step should be clearly defined and algorithm should end at any point. Now we will discuss about flow chart. What is a flow chart? Children, flow chart is a diagrammatic representation of steps to solve a problem. The steps that we write in an algorithm, we can represent those steps with the help of flow chart in a diagrammatic form. There are some advantages of flow chart. We will discuss them. First, flow chart is an excellent way of communicating the logic of a program. Whatever the logic is there, if you want to explain to others, we can use a flowchart, and it is an effective way because we are explaining with the help of diagrams. हम diagram का use कर रहे हैं, इसलिए हम अपने logic को easily explain कर सकते हैं. It is easy and efficient to analyze the problem. When we are analyzing any problem with the help of flowchart, it will be easier to understand, and then we can find the solutions for the problem. During program development cycle, flowchart plays the role as a blueprint. It helps in the program development process. It makes the development process very easy. After successful development of programs, program needs maintenance, and flowchart makes the program maintenance easy. It is also easy to convert the flowchart into any programming language code. Children, once we have drawn the flowchart, we can write the code in any programming language. Because with the help of flowchart, we have already understood the logic. जब हम प्रोग्राम का लॉजिक समझ जाते हैं तो हम किसी भी लैंग्वेज में प्रोग्राम लिख सकते हैं. फ्लो चार्ट सिंबल्स. चिल्ड्रन टू ड्रॉ अ फ्लो चार्ट वी यूज सम बेसिक सिंबल्स. फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द राउंडेड रेक्टेंगल. दिस सिंबल इज यूज एज ए स्टार्ट एंड स्टॉप बॉक्स टू रिप्रेजेंट स्टार्टिंग एंड एंडिंग ऑफ अ फ्लो चार्ट. Parallelogram is used as an input-output box used for input and output operations. Whatever the input statement or output statement we are writing in flowchart diagrams, we write in the parallelogram symbol. Rectangle. This shape is used as a processing box used for indicating processing and arithmetic calculations. Rhombus we use as a decision box. It is used to check a condition. A condition that has only two options, true or false. Small circle. Children, this used as a connectors. It is used to join different flow lines of the same flow chart. Arrow lines are known as a flow lines that indicates the flow of control. And it also used to connect the different symbols. Now we will understand how we will draw a flowchart for the finding area of circle. Children, first we will start with the start box that indicate that we are starting a flowchart. Then to calculate the area of circle, we will input R as a radius. We will write read R. We can also write input R. After getting the radius, we will do calculation processing and we will use processing box and write the statement area equals to 3.14 multiplied by R multiplied by R. After getting the result, we will print the area with the help of input output box, and once we have printed the area means result, we will AND the flowchart. So children, this way we will draw a flowchart in a computer. Now, in second example, we have to find area of a rectangle with the help of input width and length. We will use start box to indicate that we are starting a flowchart. Then we will draw a flow line and we will use input statement to input width and length, that is input W and L. After getting input, children, we will use processing box to show the calculation, that is A equals to L into W. After getting result, we will use again the input output box to indicate that we are printing the result, that is print A. And finally, we will use AND to indicate that we are completing the flow chart. In this example, we are converting temperature Fahrenheit to Celsius. For that, we will use the formula, that is 5 by 9 multiplied by F minus 32. Children, we will start our flowchart with the start box that indicates that we are starting flowchart. We will use read F to input the temperature in Fahrenheit. Then we will use a processing box to convert temperature from Fahrenheit to Celsius. After getting the result, that is temperature in Celsius, we will print the result, print C with the help of input output box. And finally, we will use AND to indicate that we have completed a flow chart. Now, when we are drawing a flow chart, we will also use a rhombus as a decision box. So children, we will understand that how can we use a decision box. During programming, when we have a condition to check that has only two options, true or false, we use decision box. Now, with the help of this example, we will understand how we will use a decision box. Children, in this question, we have to find largest number among the two different numbers entered by user. So, we will start our flowchart with the start box. Then we will input two numbers, input A and B. Children, now we will write a condition that will check that which number is greater. So we will write this condition in a decision box as A is greater than B. Now there will be only two options. Either A will be greater than B or A will be less than B. Ya to A B se bada hoga ya A B se chota hoga. If A is greater than B, then we will draw again a flow line that shows yes and we will print A. क्योंकि अगर A B से बड़ा है तो A will be the largest number, हम उसको print करेंगे and then the flow line will goes to end because it shows that we have calculated the result, we have solved the problem. In case A is less than B, children, that is the condition is false, no, then B will be greater than A. That is the reason we will print B and flow line will just go to the end because this time B is greater and we have solved the problem. So children, this way we use decision box in a flow chart. See another example. In this example, we are taking three numbers and finding the largest among three numbers. Children, we can use more than one decision box in a flow chart. First, we will use start box. Then we will read three numbers X, Y, Z. Now children, to solve the problem, first of all, we will take two numbers and check which number is a greater number among the two numbers. So we started with the if X is greater than Y. Now there will be two options. Either X will be greater than Y or X will be less than Y. Ya to X, Y se bada hoga ya fir X, Y se chota hoga. So in case of yes, if X is greater than Y, children, we will use a flow line that is indicating to the left side. In that side, we will again now we'll check the X with the Z because we have to find largest number among three numbers. Ab hum X aur Z ko compare karenge. If X is greater than Z, children, then X will be the greatest number among three numbers. Agar X Z se bhi greater hoga, to X largest number hoga. हम x को प्रिंट करेंगे एंड फ्लो लाइन विल गोस टू द स्टॉप बॉक्स. इन केस इफ x इज स्मॉलर देन z, चिल्ड्रन, देन z विल बी द ग्रेटर नंबर, सो वी विल प्रिंट द z. नाउ अगेन वी विल कम बैक टू द x इज ग्रेटर देन y कंडीशन. अगर x y से बड़ा है तब हम ये सब कंडीशंस यूज करेंगे. इन केस इफ x इज लेस देन y, दैट इज नो, then we will come to the right side and we will again compare the y and z. If y will be greater than z, then we will print y, and if y is less than z, we will print z. Kyunki agar y z se chota hoga to obviously z largest number hoga. So children, this way we will use decision boxes in a flow chart. Now we have to take care of some rules. First of all boxes should be connected with arrow lines. When we are drawing a flowchart, children, we have to use a flow lines to connect the boxes and symbols. Every flowchart has only one entry point, that is on the top, and it has only one exit point in the flowchart. And generally flowchart start from the top to bottom. We can also write from left to right, but mostly we start from the top to bottom. Thank you.